So we have region. The region is defined as the measure of the central angle subtended by an arc of a circle, which is equal to the radius of the circle. Okay. Saglit lang, dami pang pumapasok na ano. Wait lang ha, tingnan natin to. Marami pa yung... I-admit ko lang yung iba. Okay, so we have a region. Dami po mapasok late kasi dumating to. So by the way, next meeting, I would encourage everyone to please observe. Kindly observe the time, correct time, ano, para hindi tayo na didistract. Okay, so we have the region. Region is defined as the measure of the central angle subtended by an arc of a circle, which is equal to the radius of the circle. So if you are going to convert region into degree, all you have to do is, if you have one region, all you have to do is to multiply it by 180 degrees over pi. So that's equivalent to a certain degree. And if you would want to convert a degree into region, that is, you multiply it by pi over 180 degrees. Then, we have the circumference of the circle. Alam niyo yung circumference ng circle? Ang circumference ng circle, di ba yung circle parang meron kang, kung meron kang isang object na kagaya nito, nakikita niyo ba ito? Ayan, may nakita ko dito sa kalapit ko. This is the circle. Okay.
Yes po.
So, kung ito yung circle, ang circumference ng circle, yung length ng buong side. Okay. And that is 2 pi radius, which is equals to 360 degrees, di ba? So, ang total niyan is 360 degrees ang angle niya. So, that's the circumference of the circle. The length of the total arc of the circle, which is numerically equal to 2 pi times the radius. So, the subtended angle of the circle is equivalent to 360 degrees. So, one region is equivalent to 180 degrees divided by pi, and 1 degree is equals to pi over 180 degree region. So, that's how you convert the units. And take note that in writing the angles, the word regions is usually omitted. So, pag meron kayong nakita immediately na walang unit para doon sa mga angles, ibig sabihin, region yun. Pero kung merong symbol ng degree, yung parang letter O, ito yun, yung parang letter O dun sa taas, yung 180 degrees ito. Tapos yung 1, parang isang kudlit dito sa taas, ayan, minutes yun. And then kung dalawa naman yun, okay, parang apostrophe yung isa, ito double apostrophe, seconds yun. Okay, so that is 4 degrees. Pero kung walang unit, usually, hindi nila lalagyan ng unit, wala yung name na radian, that is equivalent to radian. Okay, so then the value of pi is constant. Alam na natin, ano, so physics pa lang, pinag-aralan na natin yan yung sa trigonometry at geometry. Pi is equivalent to a constant value of 3.1416, actually. Okay. So you have, these are the different units. I will not be discussing this anymore. Let me go to conversion of the units. So yan yung mga symbols natin para sa mga units. I have millimeter, centimeter, decimeter, etc. Okay. So kindly make all the necessary researches para mas maintindihan ninyo yung mga units na kakailanganin natin. Let's say 1 meter is equivalent to how many millimeter? 1 meter is equivalent to how many centimeter? 100 centimeter is equivalent to how many meters? How many, sino ang nakakaalam sa inyo? How many meters do we have for 1 kilometer?
1,000 po.
Okay. Watch, that's 1,000. And if you have 1 liter, how many cubic centimeters? Oh, sorry. 1 liter, how many milliliter? How many milliliter in 1 liter?
1,000 po.
Okay, that's good. So this is how you convert the unit. If you have centimeter to converting to mm, all you have to do is to multiply 20 centimeter by 10. 100 centimeter, convert to decimeter, you multiply it by 1 decimeter. Okay. So these are the equivalent metric measurements for 1 centimeter. That's equivalent to 10 meter, mm. And by the way, meron tayong dalawang klase ng units. Meron tayong English system. Ito yon yung mga inches, yard, mile, square mile, and lahat ng yan English. Pero meron din tayo ng SI units. Ang SI units yun yung millimeter, centimeter, meters. Okay? Hectare. So, unit for the areas are in square, millimeter, or hectare. Okay. So, for every 100 hectare, how many? That is 1 square kilometer. Importante ang solid mensuration sa architecture. Diba, no? Bakit? Sino ang po pwedeng mag-elaborate? Sino ang gusto mag-elaborate? Yes, oh yes, sino yon?
Si Pray po.
Okay, sige.
Elaborate na po, ma'am.
Yes, yes.
Kasi po kapag po, kaya po sa architecture, halimbawa po, meron pong susukating ano, gagawing bahay. Susukatin po muna yung lupa or establishment.
Ano ang kailangan nating malaman sa pagsusukat ng lupa? Kailangan nating malaman ang
area po.
Area. Bakit natin kailangan alamin muna yung area ng ano ba? Area ng lupa. Bakit kailangan muna nating alamin yung area ng lupa?
Para po sakto yung itatayong ano yung pong plan bago po para po hindi po magkaroon ng problema pag po ginagawa na.
Okay. So ibig sabihin, kailangan alam muna natin kung gaano kalaki yung lote na paglalagay natin nung building or nung structure. So kung hindi natin alam, baka ang mangyari, yung i-design natin, mas malaki yung floor area na kailangan niya kaysa dun sa paglalagyan mong sukat ng lupa. Ano? So that's very good. So that's how important the solid mensuration is in architectural studies. Okay. Aside from the area, we also have to determine the volume or the capacity. So when it comes to volume, these are the units that you are going to use. Cubic centimeter, cubic meter, o oh, diba? Usually pag tubig kasi ano, pag water na ang measurement natin, okay, cubic centimeter or isang litro, isang galon. Oh, ito yung English unit natin. This one are the SI units. Okay? So the English units yung mga square is cubic inches and pag SI unit, cubic millimeter, cubic meter. Okay? And also for the mass or the weight. I have milligram or gram, kilogram. So those are for mass. Okay, X. And you have the lengths. Okay. Sa lengths, oh, ito yung ginagamit natin pag mga linear dimension lang, yung mga one dimension. Length, yung inch, gaano ba kahaba yung isa? How many inches do we have for one foot?
12 po.
12 inches. Okay. So, bakit naman importante kailangan malaman nyo yung length? Kasi sa architectural drawing, meron kayong tinatawag na ano yon, yung 1:100. Ano tawag nyo? Scale ano? Oh, sorry ha, kasi ako ay civil engineer.
Ako po, scaling po.
That's scaling. Oo. Pag mag-scale ka, halimbawa 1:100, so kailangan alam mo yung mga unit. One unit is to how many unit of 100. Yan. So importante na alam niyo yung mga units of measurement na gagamitin ninyo. So yung area and then the volume, of course. Okay. Weight. Okay. So this is how you're going to derive the units. Okay, this is an example. If you are going to convert, let's say, for example, 45 kilometer per hour in meter per second. So 45 kilometer per hour, how many meters do we have for every kilometer?
1,000 meter.
Okay, so 1,000 meter. How many minutes do we have for every hour? 60 minutes. And how many minutes do we, how many seconds do we have for 1 minute? 60 seconds. So this is how you would notice, this is how we convert. Kung ano yung unit natin dito sa taas, dun mo ilagay yung isang unit. You would see, halimbawa ito, 45 kilometer. Yung kilometer nandun sa taas, dun sa conversion mo, para ma-convert mo, yung kilometer nandun na sa baba. Ano? So that would be equivalent to meter per hour. Then, kung i-convert mo naman yung hour, hour na nasa ilalim nung fraction, yung hour. So, yung hour naman dito sa ipang multiplier mo, nandun sa taas. Nasa, ano tawag natin dito? Sa fraction. Di ba ito, numerator? Itong isa?
Denominator
po.
Okay. Denominator po.
Okay. So, that is how you convert. So that is why 45 kilometer per hour is equivalent to 12.5 meter per second. So if you are now going to express liters in terms of cubic inches, this is how you're going to convert. So 2 liters is how many cubic inches? For every liter, 1,000 cubic centimeter. Then for every centimeter, for every inch, you have 2.54 centimeter. But take note, 1,000 cubic centimeter yon, yung equivalent ng 1 liter. So, that is why you would notice dito sa conversion, ito, bracket. Nakikita nyo ba? Do you follow?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so meron tayong bracket dito. Take note that this one is in cubic. Ibig sabihin, pag sinabi man natin cubic, anong nangyayari doon sa value natin? Minumultiply natin ng how many times by itself?
Hello.
Tatlo.
3 times po.
Okay.
3 times by itself.
Okay, so pag tatlo, pag cube ang nakalagay dyan, you multiply the unit or the value by 3 times. 3 times by itself. Okay, so you have 1 inch divided by 2.54 centimeter, and then naka-bracket yung value na yan, and you raise it to the power of 3. So that's equivalent to 122.05 cubic inches. So 2 liters is equivalent to 122.05 cubic inches. Okay. Now, this is an example of how you're going to calculate the floor area in terms of conversion of units. So let's say, for example, you have a floor area of auditorium in terms of square meter, but you are given the dimension of 250 feet by 120 feet. Okay. Since the dimension of the auditorium is 250 feet by 120 feet, how are you going to determine the area? You're going to multiply the length by the width.
Width.
Tama?
Yes po.
Okay. By the way, pag pumasok kayo next time sa ating discussion, ano ha, dala kayo ng calculator at saka ng ballpen at ng papel para makapag-take down kayo ng notes, and then kung meron tayong mga questions dito, meron tayong mga discussion na kagaya nito, you can follow. So, 250 feet by 120 feet is equivalent to, let's see, tama ba yun? Yung 30,000? Sino may calculator sa inyo dyan? Okay, let's see.
Yes po.
Tama, 30,000.
Tama po.
Yes po.
So that's 250 times 120, 30,000 square feet. So if you would want to convert that into square meter, for every meter, that's equivalent to 3.28 feet. So that's why we have here 1 meter over 3.28 feet. But take note again that the unit is in square feet. So what we are going to do now is to use the power of 2. So 1 meter divided by 3.28 feet raised to 2. Again, naka-bracket yung fraction na yon, and then when you raise it to 2, that's 2,788.5 square meter. So that's the floor area of the auditorium in terms of SI unit, that is in terms of square meter. Okay, next. Which of the two measures of distances, 100 meter and 100 yard, used for dashes and track and fields is longer? And how many feet is it longer? So you're going to use one common unit of measurement here para ma-check natin which is longer between 100 meter and 100 yard. So if you are going to convert 100 yard in meter, you would have here 100 yard multiplied by, for every 1 yard, that's equivalent to 0.9144 meters. So that is equivalent to 91.44 meters. So, ibig sabihin, 100 yard is equivalent to 91.44 meters. E comparing it to the 100 meter, alin ang mas mahaba? Siyempre, yung 100 meters. How did you come up with the 8.56 meters here? So, 100 meters minus 91.44 meters, that is 8.56 meters. So, the 100 meter is longer by 8.56 meters comparing it to 100 yard. Okay. If you are going now to convert both in terms of feet, because how many feet is it longer is one of the questions in the problem. So you have 100 yard, you multiply it by 3 feet divided by 1 yard. So that's equivalent to 300 feet. Or 100 meter, you multiply it by 3.28 feet for every 1 meter. That is equivalent to 328 feet. So if you are going to compare the two, the 100 meter is longer by 28 feet. You have 328 feet minus 100 feet is 28 feet. So mas malaki ng, in terms of feet, mas malaki yung 100 meters by 28 feet. Okay, so that's how you convert the units. Now, in the solid mensuration, and our first topic will be the polyhedrons and prisms. So when we talk about the polyhedrons and prisms, ito yung mga examples natin ng figure na polyhedrons and prisms. So how many sides do we have here? Elan, nakikita nyo?
Five.
We have five sides. Okay. How do you call the polygon with five sides?
Pentagon po.
Pentagon. Good.
Pentagon po.
Can we have a polygon with two sides only?
No po.
Oh, what's the minimum number of side para makabuo tayo ng polygon?
Three.
Very good. Three. That is a
triangle.
Triangle. So we have a triangle. Pag four sides, ano nang tawag natin?
Square.
Ha? Pag four sides?
Cube.
Nende. Ano square tayo? Polygon pa lang tayo. Polygon.
Square.
Or pwedeng rectangle. Okay. Pag five sides?
Pentagon.
Pentagon.
Six sides?
Hexagon.
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 Oh, pag six sides, ilan?
Hexagon.
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 Pag seven?
Heptagon.
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 Pag eight?
Octagon.
Octagon.
Oh, pag nine?
Nonagon.
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 Pag ten?
Decagon.
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 Pag 11,
nonanagon po.
Ha? Pag 11,
nonanagon po.
Andekagon. Walang nananagon. Andekagon.
Andekagon.
O, pag 12, hindi ko na rin alam. Research na rin natin, ha?
Dodekagon.
Oo, andekagon pag 11. Undekagon. Andekagon. Okay? So this is polyhedrons and prisms. This is how a polyhedron and a prism would look like. So these are the figures. So this is a tetrahedron, a figure 3.1.3. And then this one is a hexahedron. Then this one is an octahedron, dodecahedron, and you have icosahedron. Okay, these are examples of polyhedrons and prisms. And presuming that the different or the regular polyhedron is bounded by pieces of cardboard, each is cut to some edges and you're going to spread the faces of the five polygons, these are the following patterns which you can form. This one is a pattern na po pwede nating ma-form para sa isang pyramid. Pero tayo makakagawa pa tayo ng prism na kagaya nito. Pwede itong cube.
Okay. Cube.
Okay. Ito, ano kaya ang pwedeng mabuo nito? Itong pangatlong figure na to. Anong possible?
Octahedron.
Ha?
Octahedron.
Sige nga, later on natin to tingnan ha kung ano mabubuo niya ng mga patterns. So, these are polyhedrons and prisms. These are right prism. By the way, meron tayong dalawang klase ng prism. Yung isa right, yung isa oblique. Pag sinabi nating oblique, ano yung oblique na para siyang tilted. Pero pag right prism, at right angle. Okay, so kagaya nito. Ano pang ibig sabihin, by the way, natin ng right angle?
90 degrees.
How do we form a right angle? Two lines at 90 degrees with each other, you form an angle which is right angle.
Okay.
So, pag oblique,
45.
Not necessarily 45, pero meron siyang angle. Basta naka-angled siya in terms of pwedeng angle relative.
Pero same pa rin po.
Oo. Parang ganito, ano ba? Hindi ako kita sa video.
Okay.
Kita nyo ba ako sa video?
Yes, ma'am.
Sige, para ma-illustrate lang natin ng konti.
Yes, po.
Yeah, yes, po.
Pag oblique, ito, angle dyan. Meron siyang angle. Pero magkikreate ka. Pag oblique, pwedeng may angle siya dito. Not necessarily 45 degrees ha. Ma, pwede siyang naka ano, ibang iba-ibang angles. Pwedeng mas maliit ang slope, mas mataas ang slope, pwedeng steeper ang slope or pwedeng lower ang slope natin. So yun yung oblique. That's oblique prism. So this one is an example of hexagonal, oblique hexagonal. So these are examples of prisms. Okay, prisms are triangular, pwedeng quadrangular, depending on the bases. So kung ano yung number of sides ng base, doon nakabase yung pangalan ng prism. So kung ang base niya is triangular, yan, kagaya nito, figure na to, yan, ang tawag natin dyan, triangular prism. Right dahil at right angle siya. Yung itong vertical na to, member, is also at 90 degrees with this one. Okay. So, kaya yung base natin is at 90 degrees with the vertical or the altitude or the height of the prism. So, this is a right triangular prism. This one is a right pentagonal prism. So, you would notice, kaya tinawag siyang pentagonal, how many sides ang base natin? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bases. 5. Ang pentagonal. Kaya ito, right pentagonal prism. Okay, next. We have, what are the different properties of prisms? So we have the basic properties of prisms. The bases are equal parallel polygons. Lateral faces are parallelograms. And in case of right prisms, the lateral faces are rectangles. The lateral area or the lateral surface of a prism is the sum of the areas of the lateral faces. The total area or the total surface of a prism is the sum of the lateral area and the areas of the two bases. And the lateral edges are equal and parallel, while the altitude of the prism is the perpendicular distance between the bases. And in the case of right prism, the lateral edges are equal to the altitude. So the section of a prism made by parallel planes cutting all the lateral edges are what you call as equal polygon. So let's say, for example, for this, alin ba ang base? Ang base natin yun, yung triangle. Okay. How many, kaya pag ang tanong, how many sides ang bases natin, ang base natin dito? 3 sides. Pag ang tanong naman is altitude, ang altitude ito. Yan, yung height ng prism. Okay? So, lateral area, yung description natin ng lateral area, sum of the areas of lateral faces. Eh, ano ba yung lateral faces? Lateral faces are rectangles. That is in case of a right prism. Okay, so later on, discuss din natin yan pag susolve natin ang problem. Ito yung isang example problem natin. So the lateral edge, 6 meters of an oblique square prism is inclined at an angle of 30 degrees with the altitude. So this is the altitude. The question is, what is the altitude of the prism? So the altitude here in the figure is given by the symbol H. And take note that the lateral edge, ito yung lateral edge, is given as 6 meters. So that is why you have here 6 meters. Since we are going to determine the altitude of the prism, we are going to determine here the height, the H. And take note that the prism is angled at 30 degrees with the altitude. So if this is the altitude and this is the lateral edge makes an angle of 30 degrees with the altitude. Okay? So this is H, this is 6 meters, and this angle subtended by the altitude and the lateral edge is 30 degrees. Now, how do we determine the value of H? If you are going to represent a, ano ba ang tawag dito? Imaginary line from here hanggang doon sa base ng triangle. Imaginary line ito. So you have the value of h here. And then, ito dotted line din. Imaginary line din natin yung dotted line na yan. Okay? So if you are going to use trigonometry, sige nga, balik tayo sa trigonometry. Anong alam yung trigonometric function? Anong alam yung trigonometric
function? So, katawa po.
Okay.
So, katawa po.
Oh, sige. Sa tangent muna tayo. Tangent. How do you determine the tangent of an angle? That is the ratio between what?
Opposite and
Opposite over adjacent.
Yan. Opposite over adjacent. May nakita ko. Oo, may narinig kasi ako kanina ng opposite over hypotenuse. That is na tangent, ha? Ang tangent is opposite over adjacent. Oo, tanawa. Oo, tanawa. Opposite over adjacent. Ibig sabihin, opposite of the angle divided by adjacent to the angle, that is tangent of the angle. Naintindihan ba yon?
Opo, ma'am.
Opo, yes, ma'am.
So, our reference is the angle. Ayong, ang reference natin ay yung angle. Opposite the angle, adjacent to the angle. So, balik tayo dito sa figure na to. Etong H, ano to? Opposite or adjacent?
Adjacent.
Adjacent po.
Okay.
Adjacent.
Okay. Adjacent to the 30 degrees. How about yung 6?
Hypotenuse.
Yeah. Hypotenuse.
Okay. So that is hypotenuse. If this is adjacent over hypotenuse, what trigonometric function is applicable?
Cosine.
Adjacent over hypotenuse. That is cosine. Tama, cosine. Cosine of 30 degrees is equals to h over 6. So if you are going to determine the value of h, that is equals to 6 times multiply of times cosine of 30 degrees. Or that's equivalent to square root of 3 over 2. Or kung hindi naman kayo gumagamit ng radical, ang radical yung meron tayong square root, ha? Radical sign. Pwede ninyong i-convert into ano ang equivalent nito? 3 point something. Ano? Meron, i-convert ninyo into decimal places. Pwedeng into decimal places. By the way, ang ating ruling is laging hanggang dun sa 2 decimal places. Okay, significant decimal places tayo lagi, ha, ang answer natin. So kung meron kayong answer, you convert it to halimbawa 3.1416, gawin nyo lang 3.14. So parang ganon, yun ang ating ano, gamit, yun ang ruling natin. Our convention, sign convention. Para pare-parehas tayo ng magiging answer later on. Kung hindi naka-radical, naka-decimal places. Okay? So this is how you determine the value of h. So as simple as this. Okay? You determine the altitude of the prism. Now this one is an example of another prism. So this one is an isosceles trapezoid. By the way, ano ba ibig sabihin natin ng isosceles? Alam nyo isosceles triangle?
Sides are equal po.
Okay.
Sides are equal po.
Oo. Pag isosceles, two sides are equal. Okay. That's very good. So in the problem, the base of the prism is an isosceles trapezoid. 10 meters from its upper base with equal sides of 2 meters and inclined at the base at 45 degrees. So what we are going to do is to compute the area of the trapezoid. You would notice, ito yung trapezoid. 10 meters daw yung upper base. Mali, paki-check nyo ito ha. Itong figure na to, mali yung 10 units na ito ha. This is supposed to be, ano ba ito? The base of the prism is an isosceles trapezoid for its upper base with equal sides of 2 meters inclined at the base of 45 degrees. Etong 10 na ito ay simula lang dito hanggang doon. Na baka malito kasi kayo, hindi yun yung buong ito ha. Ito yung 10, ito. Kasi kung 10 meters ito, 10 meters din. Kung maglagay ka ng imaginary line dito na naka 90 degrees or at right angle, 10 meters din yung distance. Simula dito sa point na to hanggang dito sa point na ito. Okay? So, ibig sabihin, kailangan nating malaman pa simula dito hanggang doon, simula dito hanggang doon, para makuha natin yung distance from this point hanggang dito sa point na ito. Paki-check nyo na lang yung figure ha, kasi pag nag-discuss ako, kailangan talaga natin ng figure. So, kailangan makita nyo dun sa screen yung figure. So, since this is 45 degrees and this one is 2 meters, you can determine the value of this x. You can also determine the value of this distance. Okay, so nakuha niya yung value ng x. Ang value daw ng x is square root of 2. So, if you are going to determine the area of the trapezoid, anong formula ng area ng trapezoid? 1 half base 1 plus base 2 times height. Okay, kaya meron itong 2. 1 half yun. Formula ng trapezoid, 1 half is equals to base 1
B1
plus B2 times
height.
Times height. Okay. Again, area of trapezoid is 1 half multiplied by the sum of base 1 plus base 2 multiplied by height. So, etong 10 plus 2 is square root of 2, ito yung base na nasa ilalim. Okay? Etong 10 plus 2 is square root of 2. Square root of 2 kasi dalawa ito. Ito kasi yung square root of 2. X din ito eh. So, square root of 2. Kasi kung 45 degrees ito, kung ito ay X, X din ito. Itong sa baba. Okay? Kaya ito, simula dito, sa distance na ito hanggang dito, 2 is square root of 2 yun. So, ito, square root of 2 ito. So, dalawa yun, kaya 2 times square root of 2. Tapos, dagdag natin yung 10. So, ibig sabihin, itong 10 plus 2 square root of 2, yun yung base na ito. Yung 10, itong isang 10 na ito, ito yun, yung 10. Itong 2 sa ilalim, yun yung 1 half. And then, yung square root of 2, okay, that is the value of x, which is also the altitude, square root of 2. So, that is why the area of the trapezoid is 10 square root of 2 plus 2 square meter. So, pwede itong i-convert into decimal kung hindi naka-radical. Okay? And then, of course, we have the polyhedrons and prism. So, this is an example of a lateral edge of a square prism. So, you have a 60 degrees with the base. The altitude of the prism is determined if the lateral edge is 3 centimeter, square root of 3, I mean, square root of 3 centimeter. So, ang 60 degrees natin doon na. Ito. Kasi naka-angle daw yung base, okay, with the base with the lateral edge. So, ito yung lateral edge. Ito lateral edge din ito. Ito lateral edge din. So, kung ito yung base, meron tayong 60 degrees dito. Okay? So, pwede nating makuha yung value ng altitude na h. Kasi ito, hypotenuse, square root of 3 ang value nun. So, that is why you have h is 3 halves centimeter. Okay? So, may question pa ba kayo? I think I am finished with this one. May tanong pa kayo? Have any question?
Wala po.
Wala.
Wala po.
Wala po.
Wala po.
Okay. Okay, wala, wala talaga kayong question? For the meantime, you can proceed doing your pretest. And then later on, I will be posting again in the Google Classroom for another assessment for our discussion today. And I will be meeting you. Just be updated through the GC. Okay, I am going medyo ano lang tayo ngayon. Pinuto lang natin kasi meron pa akong meron akong meeting. So anyway, next meeting I will find the ways para maayos ulit. Mas maganda siguro yung ganitong time na ano, yung mahaba kasi marami yung mga computations. So anyway, we're going to make some scheduling dun sa ating online synchronous discussion. Wala kayong question, pero meron naman kayong natutunan.
Opo. Meron po.
Yes po.
Meron po.
Yes po, meron po.
Meron po.
Sige. So, kung wala na kayong tanong, I will see you next meeting. Kindly browse over your G Classroom, Google Classroom, and by the way, yung pag-a-answer ninyo nung ano ha, nung assignment, wag ninyong i-send ay sa email ko. I-send ninyo, i-hand in ninyo dun sa Google Classroom, classwork, kung saan ako nag-post ng assignment. Ah, dun ninyo ito turn in. Do not forget to turn in. Kasi ibig sabihin noon, na-submit nyo na sa akin para malalagyan natin siya ng grade. Once it is graded, it will be returned to you para naman merong feedback sa inyo. Okay? Huwag niyong i-send sa email ko, ha?
Okay po.
Oh, sige. Huwag doon sa email ko lang ninyo i-send. Doon sa Google Classroom, sa classwork. Wala talaga kang issue. Yung for, ano ha, learner's progress monitoring report, isi-send ko na lang later on sa inyo yon.
Okay, ma'am.
Yung form.
Okay
ano
po.
Yung guideline
okay
niyo. You can make use of the new LMS. Nandun yung ibang mga learning materials, yung ibang mga videos at saka ibang mga posted na learning materials. Pero meron din doon sa Google Classroom. Later on, magpo-post din ako doon sa Google Classroom. Okay? Wala na talaga?
Wala po.
Wala na po.
Wala na po.
Sige, kung wala na, you may leave the room.
Wala na po.
And I am also going to end this meeting. See you all next week.
Thank you, ma'am.
Oo, kasi yung may gagawin kayo doon sa pretest, para pasubmit na lang ng mga assignments yung mga works ninyo. Okay? Sige.
Okay,
God bless you all. See you next meeting.
Thank you,
thank
ma'am.
You po.
Ingat, ma'am.
Thank you po, ma'am. Ingat po.
Thank you
po.
Salamat po, ma'am.
Thank you po.
Salamat po. Thank you po.
End ko na ito, ha?
Thank you po, ma'am.
Apo, ma'am.